It's been hailed as a monument to Thatcherism, Europe's biggest cable-stayed bridge, officially joined by the Transport Secretary today.
What we are seeing is the beginning of the end of the massive congestion that has plagued so many hundreds of thousands of people every day and every week for a long period of time.
The crossings cost £86 million of private money, put up by a consortium led by Trafalgar House. But it's regarded as a public necessity, giving hope to thousands of motorists constantly stuck in jams at the Dartford Tunnel. Such congestion couldn't have been imagined when it first opened. Building started 3 years ago. The project's been praised for its rapid progress, towering hundreds of feet above the Thames. The main foundations of the bridge were towed by tug from the Netherlands. The superstructure put in place by one of the largest inshore cranes in the world, holding it all in place, 750,000 steel bolts. It's the first road bridge to be built downstream from the City of London since Tower Bridge in 1894, and it's hoped the benefits it's predicted to bring will have a dynamic effect on the local economy. The bridge opens in October. Tolls will operate a high-tech tagging system, and each crossing will cost the car driver 80 pence.